I decided to do a tribute to you, Em. It's harder than I thought it would be. It's been 7 years. I should be able to handle this. But as I flip through the photos, the memories of you crash on me like a wave. How can I properly share the essence of Emily Dawn Membury with others? You were so much more than these 2D images. You were always so impatient to be grown up, Em. In my eyes, you're always leaps and bounds ahead of me, even though you were only a year older. You were spitfire through and through. You were hell on wheels, loud, caring, and passionate. No one could give a glare like you, or swear as much in one sentence. It was always us against the big boys. It was rough being the two youngest and the only girls in the pack of 6 boys. My brothers, Jamie, Matt, and Craig. Our cousins, Luke and Casey. And your brother, Aaron. They tried to toughen us up for life, and we survived together somehow. I don't have many pictures of teenaged you, as none of us had digital cameras. It's something I'll always regret, that they hadn't become household items yet. When you died, us kids tried to look after the adults the best we could. Aunt Linda and Uncle Gil, my mom Debbie, and your parents Kathy and David, most of all. I don't know if any of us can forgive God for taking you away at 17. Only 87 would have been acceptable. When you grow up as part of a set, it's difficult to continue on solo. We were paired together so much. Birthdays were always together. Luke was included too. I don't particularly like my birthday anymore. It's just not the same without you. Your funeral was the most difficult thing our family has ever faced. I remember bits and pieces of it in blurry fragments. My most vivid memory is also the saddest. It was Jamie. Jamie had always been the king of the pack to us. He was the oldest, the biggest trickster, and all-around ruler of us kids. At your funeral, everyone had been told if we wished to, we could speak. Jamie was the only one able to give a eulogy that day. It was beautiful, eloquent, and perfectly represented the feelings of all of us kids. One part has always stuck in my mind. I've been away at school for many years now. It seems like only yesterday she was this little girl running around. To me, she'll always be that little girl. I was one of the few people that had a side view of him at that time. My superhero strong older brother clung to that podium. His knuckles were white, and it was the only thing keeping him standing. Em, your death rocked us in so many ways. Years later, and this is the first time I've been able to put together all the photos of you. Now I treasure every blurry photograph I find of you. My greatest wish is to hear you call me one last time. You're gone now, but I'll never say goodbye. I'll see you on the other side, dear cousin of mine.